What's up YouTube, JP here, and in this video we're taking another look at the Steam Deck. This time I'm going to show you how to install non-Steam games. So without further delay, let's dive in. So in a previous Steam Deck video I showed you how to copy files across to the Steam Deck, whether it's from a USB hard drive or thumbstick, or over the network through a network share. If you haven't seen that video yet, click up here. It's going to be detrimental to this video because we're going to be installing non-Steam games. So I got hold of this repack and now we're going to copy it across to the Steam Deck. So for this video I use an external SSD, and it's actually an M.2 enclosure that I have an M.2 drive in. Now of course, if you checked out the last Steam Deck video, you will see there's quite a few different ways that we can get files onto the Steam Deck. So just to get you up to speed, I used one of these to actually transfer the repack install, and I'm going to use that on the Steam Deck. So let's jump on over to the Steam Deck and see about getting this copied across and set up. Actually, before we jump on the Steam Deck, let's go on the PC and see how I got this set up for this external SSD. Now, as you can see here, I've got the repack on the drive itself already. This is 72 gigabytes, so it will take some time. Now, if we have a look at the SSD file system, it's actually XFAT, and that's absolutely fine for the Steam Deck. It can read it. FAT32 is no good here because some files will exceed that 4 gigabyte limit. Right, now let's go over to the Steam Deck. So we've turned the Steam Deck on and we're in game mode. So you'll need to push the Steam button, go down to power, and then switch to desktop. So now we're in desktop mode and you can see I've just plugged in the SSD, that external drive. It says we've got the SSD and we've got a primary. The primary is always the micro SD card. So let's open that SSD, and as you can see, we've got the repack just here. Now the best thing to do is just drag and drop it onto the desktop because it'll install a lot quicker that way. So let's fast forward until this is copied across. So now we have that copied across and it's finished, we can close the SSD. We're not going to need that anymore. So if you open up the repack that you've just copied to the desktop, you'll find the setup.exe. If you right click on it, then click add to Steam. What this is going to do, it's going to add that setup.exe to your Steam library. So next, we're going to open Steam. It opened on another screen, that's why you see me dragging it across. Now we're going to look for that setup.exe, and that's exactly what it's going to be named, as you can see here. So once you click on it, you're going to click on the cog, and then click Properties. Once you see this screen, go to Compatibility, and then Force Compatibility. Now a lot of people will say experimental, but that didn't work for me, so I use 7.06. Now this next step is optional if you want to install it onto the SD card, which I do. I don't want to take up all the space on the internal SSD. So if you open up the file manager and go to primary, I'm going to create a folder called games. Now of course, again, this is optional. You can install it on the internal SSD, but as I've got a 512GB micro SD card, I'm going to stick it on there. So if you go into the games folder and then click on the top where it says games, you're going to have the path. Now you want to copy this because we're going to paste it somewhere else. So again, we're going to go to the cog and we're going to go to properties. Now where it says launch options, we're going to add something here. So what we're going to type in here is steam_compat_mounts=, and then we're going to put quotes and then paste that path in we copied and then end it with quotes. And then you can put in a space, %%, %%. Now, of course, don't worry, I will also put this command in the description below. So now you can click play. But it's not play to play the game, it's to start the setup. Now I had this funny little update thing. I just waited for it to be finished, closed it, and then hit play again. So once you hit play, you might not get that update. If you don't, it's basically going to go through the install process. as you can see, here's the install process. Now it's actually asking you to push the up arrow on the keyboard. You could do this with the on-screen keyboard, but I actually have a wireless keyboard attached. On my keyboard, I had to push shift and then up. Now, of course, you can just click install. You can click proceed here. I know you can't read everything, but there's actually no option, so just click proceed. And then at this point, untick all three of these. Now you don't actually need any of these options because they're more to do with a Windows install, not a Steam Deck Linux install. And that's what we're doing here. Now, of course, we have mounted the SD card, so we can install to it now. That was that command we put in launch options. So if you click on the three dots, we're looking for the D or the E drive. Now, in my case, it was the D drive. We can see that games folder and then we can click OK. So that's actually going to install it on the SD card. Here we have a bunch of options. Now, of course, I'm English speaking, so I only want to install the English version. Obviously, you would pick the language that you wanted. I'm going to leave the 4K and full HD videos and the extra content. Then I'm going to hit proceed. So of course, as you know, this might take some time. So let's jump ahead to when this install is done. So as you can see, it took just over 38 minutes. And that's not too bad considering we install into an SD card. You might get the Doddy repack site pop up, just close it down. Now we can get rid of the setup.exe because it's now installed. So if you go back over to the cog and then click on manage, you should be able to remove non-Steam game from your library. Excellent, that's now gone. So the next step is to open your primary micro SD card and go into the games folder, and then you should see the installation folder for the repack you installed. Now we're looking for the exe that starts the game. So we're going to go into ph, work, bin, x86, and then we can see the exe to start the game. And then just like before, right click and then add to Steam. Now, just to note here, your exe file might not be in that location depending on the game. If you can't find it, just do a search for .exe in that install folder. So here we go, we found the actual game that we added. And then again, we're gonna click on the cog, properties, compatibility, and then we're going to force compatibility and I'm going to change it back to 7.06. So once this is done, you're actually ready to launch the game. But before we go ahead and test it out, I want to quickly show you how to get newer version of the Proton compatibility layer. So of course, we are on desktop mode and we're going to go to the App Store. Now what you can type in at the top is Proton Up. And what this is going to show you is an application called protonup-qt. So go ahead and install that. Once it's finished installing, you can close out of the store. Click on the Steam icon and then go down to utilities and you'll see it there, protonup-qt. So go ahead and launch it. Now, as long as it's selected Steam at the top, that should be fine. That's the only option I actually had. Then click on add version and you want to select GE Proton. Then for the version, just go for the highest version there is and click install. So once this is all installed, you're going to want to restart stroke reboot the Steam Deck. So let's go ahead and restart the Steam Deck, obviously after it's finished installing. That's such a cool animation. I love the startup of the Steam Deck. Now I have that custom boot animation. So if we go to the cog again, click on properties, compatibility, we will see I've got that new option available to me. So now we've got that sorted, let's go ahead and start the game. Now, just so you know, I have sped up this footage 8 times. And that's not because it took a ridiculous amount of time to load. It's just there's a lot of boring stuff to go through. cutscenes, setting up options, and then reading this EULAR agreement. So I've put it to 8x speed, and I'll slow it back down as soon as we get into gameplay. But as you can see, this game's working, it's installed, and everything seems to be fine. So let's check out how it runs. Now I will admit, it doesn't look great at first glance. We're only getting around 40 FPS, there's a few dips and stutters, and obviously we've got really bad screen tearing. But I haven't actually gone in and changed any settings yet. We can of course dial things in to get a much better experience. But for the purpose of this video, I just wanted to show you how to actually get non-Steam games, especially repacks, installed on the Steam Deck. And of course, it doesn't have to be this game. I'm not saying it can be any game, because I dare say not every game will work, but you can check it out on certain sites to see if it will actually run. Obviously, you can always search on YouTube, put in the game that you're after, Steam Deck after it, and then if you see any videos, then you're pretty much guaranteed that you're going to be able to get it installed. So that wasn't too difficult. And in summary, there is a lot of different ways you can install non-Steam games. There's a few different applications you can use, but I found that this is the nice, simple, easy way to get it set up. Now, one thing I just wanted to let you guys know, actually recording footage on the Steam Deck has become a bit of a pain for me. I'm having to use dongles, adapters. It's getting to the point where I need a dock, a proper dock for the Steam Deck. Now, I did look at buying the official Steam Deck dock, but that was £79 in the UK. And I had a look on Amazon and I found a really nice one that's metal finish and it's only £30. So that's a massive saving. I will actually be doing a review of that third party dock on the channel very soon. So I'm going to end the video here. If you enjoy my content, please like, subscribe, and don't forget to hit that bell icon so you don't miss any future uploads. I'm JP, you've been watching Alien Retro Gaming, and as always, I'll catch you in the next one.